For more than 60 years, the B-52 Stratofortress has proved its intrinsic worth by wreaking havoc on our enemies and strategically defending America from threats of catastrophic proportions.
It is America's big stick. It is one of the longest serving aircraft in U.S. inventory.
In one word to describe the B-52, I would say adaptable.
Awesome. I'd call it capable.
Outstanding.
Firepower.
Awe-inspiring. Seeing it in close in person and watching it do what it does and being able to get inside of it and actually go perform that mission, that's pretty awe-inspiring, both to us to do it and people to get to see it. So.
The B-52 Stratofortress, referred to as the Buff,
it's a big, ugly, fat, flying fortress,
was designed and developed by the Boeing Aircraft Company, who made continuous improvements to the various models.
The bomber has gone through changes conventionally for the amount of weapons it can carry, externally and internally as well.
Two prototypes, the XB-52 and the YB-52, were created as test models. As the aircraft became successful, models A through H were designed, each with slight modifications. Boeing began development in the early 1940s, after the United States and Great Britain initiated programs aimed at developing a bomber that could take off from bases in North America and devastate targets in Europe.
But I'm pretty sure it scares them, because they know there's a pretty good heavy payload coming their way, and they can try to hide, but good luck with that.
The specifications for such a bomber required speed exceeding 450 miles per hour with a service ceiling of more than 40,000 feet, the ability to reach 5,000 miles with a payload of 10,000 pounds of bombs.
The power and deterrent that it carries is awesome.
Between the 1950s and early 1960s, 744 B-52s were built.
It's kind of cool to think about it, that somebody's grandpa or great-grandpa worked on the same jet that I'm working on right now.
The first operational version was the B-52B, which took its first flight in December of 1954. The B-52B entered service on June 29, 1955, with the 93rd Heavy Bombardment Wing at Castle Air Force Base in California. On October 26, 1962, the last B-52H left the factory, ending the B-52's production.
Still competitive in its nature, despite as aging as the aircraft is, its basic foundation is very, very well up to date.
The last B-52H, tail number 61-040, is stationed at Minot Air Force Base and is still in service today. Currently, Minot Air Force Base is only one of two bases still operating with the B-52H Stratofortress. Minot Air Force Base received its first B-52H model on July 16, 1961, while under Strategic Air Command.
It's kind of an honor to be a part of a legacy that's going to last 100 years. So to be a part of that and to know that, you know, I won't be the last guy to fly the B-52 and to be able to employ this aircraft in a combat environment, I feel honored to do that.
Since arriving to Minot Air Force Base in 1961, the B-52H has flown nearly 300,000 hours.
I love the airplane. It's a good airplane. The fact that every time I've flown it, it's good to have 8 engines. If anything happens, you know, you're always going to bring it home safe. It's a well-built aircraft.
On January 10th and 11th, 1962, Minot Air Force Base's B-52H completed a record-breaking 12,532.8-mile unrefueled trip from Kandina Air Base, Okinawa, to Torrejon Air Base, Spain.
You might do a long endurance mission. I've done one over 24 hours. You might be doing close air support, you know, get to drop weapons with folks on the ground. Just a total variety, from mining to high-level bombing. Anything you want to do, you can do it in the B-52.
The Strategic Air Command, famously known as SAC, was the operational establishment in charge of America's land-based strategic bomber aircraft and strategic nuclear arsenal from 1946 to 1992. The SAC command was disestablished, and the B-52Hs became part of Air Combat Command. In 2010, all B-52 Stratofortresses were again transferred under Air Force Global Strike Command. When the B-52 entered into service, SAC intended for the aircraft to be used to deter and counteract the vast and modernizing military of the Soviet Union.
The B-52 is known throughout the world as a strategic bomber. It's got a very unique shape in the sky, and it flies at a very distinct angle in the sky. So it is renowned throughout the world, and it does instill a lot of fear.
As the Soviets increased their nuclear capabilities, the Eisenhower administration began to focus on destroying the forces that would deliver deadly nuclear strikes.
The B-52 is nuclear deterrence, airman to airman, wingtip to wingtip, from the ground up.
During the Cold War, the B-52 and other national strategic bombers performed 24-hour airborne alert patrols. Bombers remained at high altitudes near Soviet Union airspace, which allowed for rapid first strike capability in the event of nuclear war. These Stratofortresses formed one deterrent component of the United States nuclear triad. By the late 1950s, surface-to-air missiles threatened high-altitude aircraft. This changed the mission of the B-52 to serve as a low-level penetration bomber on tactical targets within the Soviet Union.
Symbols of American air power, you don't get more iconic than the B-52.
During the Vietnam War, the B-52's first combat mission operation was Arclight. During this mission, 30 B-52Fs from the 9th and 441st Bombardment Squadron struck south of Vietnam on June 18, 1965. Of the 30 Stratofortresses, 27 dropped on a 1 mile by 2 mile target with altitudes between 19,000 and 22,000 feet. Altogether, more than 50% of the bombs fell within the target zone. Operation Linebacker began on May 9th and continued through October 23rd of 1972 when the United States 7th Air Force and the Navy's Task Force 77 conducted an aerial strike against North Vietnam. The purpose of Operation Linebacker was to slow the transport of supplies and materials to the Easter Offensive.
It definitely is known for Linebacker 2, carpet bombing.
Following Operation Linebacker was Operation Linebacker 2. This operation started on 18 December and continued through 29 December 1972, when the United States 7th Air Force and the Navy's Task Force 77 bombed targets in North Vietnam during the final stages of the United States' involvement in the Vietnam War.
It's a force to be reckoned with. It's not something that's just here for show. If it's ever called upon, it is ready.
Operation Linebacker 2 was the largest heavy bomber strike launched by the United States Air Force since World War II. The B-52's capabilities were emphasized during this operation rather than focusing on small tactical fighter operations, making it more successful.
The aircraft still has the capability to enforce national security anywhere in the world with overwhelming firepower.
Many have argued that if the B-52 had been allowed to continue bombing, it would have won the war. Today, the B-52 has the capacity to loiter for extended periods of time and deliver precision standoff and direct fire munitions. As of 2012, there are 77 B-52s that are still actively in service. Constant upgrades through 2015 to the B-52H will enable it to continue to strike fear in the hearts of our enemies, deterring them from actions against the United States well into the 2040s.